Welcome to the video response to James Yeager and Reed. What we're going to do today is talk about three issues. We engaged in a little bit of the comments over there on their channel in the discussion. And one of them was about the 7.62 by 39 and limited penetration ammo. And the fact that not all hunter points are created equal. The second area is the discussion of 30-06 versus 7.62 Nato. And then the last one is 5.56 versus 7.62 Nato. We'll start with the 7.62 by 39. Pretty much most of the hollow point ammunition that's out there that's Russian origin does not expand. And it's made on the same tooling and has the same jackets as the full metal jacket ammo, and that's why. But you, as a user of the 7.62 by 39, if you're going to choose to employ that for home defense, then it's your responsibility to pick or have made ammunition that is suitable for the task. If you want limited penetration ammunition for home defense, we have some bullets listed up here that, when loaded in the 7.62 by 39 cartridge, would serve admirably. So we'll zoom in on that and give you a look. So the suggestions we have up here, these are all plinking and varmint bullets. They're designed to expand on small animals, woodchucks, etc. So they would have very limited penetration. They would not be much use against body armor and limit penetration. So these are special purpose use for the 7.62 by 39. And although they are 308 diameter bullets, they will work in the 7.62 by 39 with no problem. Years ago, before commercially available ammunition was on the market, we used to load a lot of ammunition for the 7.62 by 39 to feed our weapons. Up here we have the 30 caliber TNT 125 grain hollow point, 110 grain varmint or hollow point, 100 grain plinker half jacket, and then lastly the 100 grain spire point. You can look at both Hornaday and Spear websites and get further information on these bullets. Next we have the interesting video that James and Reed did on the 7.62 Nato versus the 5.56 millimeter. This is a question that has no basis in reality, and the reason is assault rifle cartridges, whether it's the 5.56 millimeter, the 5.45, or the 7.62 by 39, or for that fact, the 8 by 33, or the 7.62 by 45, these rounds are viable as long as you have support weapons to bridge the gap in engagement distance. The whole question of one versus the other is immaterial. What you do is you pick the correct weapon for the mission. And in a military context, you will always see supporting weapons, whether they're 30 caliber, 8 millimeter, 50 cal, used in conjunction with assault rifles. This gives you standoff capacity, where you can engage targets at a distance where the assault rifle is not effective. In a self-defense or a personal defense type of situation, or a raw situation, your selection of 5.56 or 7.62 NATO is determined by your range of engagement, and that's all it is to it. The 30-06 versus a 7.62 NATO discussion is the one that interests me the most. This is one area of applicability that we discuss on my channel. On my channel, we look at asymmetrical warfare, raw, and basically using what you have available to get the job done. There is a major difference between the 7.62 NATO and the 30-06 cartridge. And this comes from the prevalent use of heavy ball in the 30-06. The 30-06 can successfully use heavy ball ammunition. And we'll get into why that's important in a minute. Basically, a lot of us still use a 30-06 round. Also use 8 millimeter. And as you get into other cartridges, we're going to look at basically two groups of cartridges here, and they share similar characteristics. On one hand, you have the 7.62 Nato with 147 grain ammunition. You have the 7.5 French, the 7.65x53, usually called an Argentine Mauser, and lastly the 7x57. These cartridges' effective range is limited by their use of light ball ammunition. And one thing a lot of people don't consider is these are also machine gun cartridges. So these rounds, when you set your machine gun up on a tripod and you're engaging at extreme range, they have an extreme range of about 3,300 yards. When we come over to this other category, we have the 30-06, the 8x57, which is 8mm Mauser, the 7.62x54R, and the 303 British. They use heavy ball ammunition in order to extend the extreme range. When you look at the 1917 water-cooled machine gun, the rear sight has two range scales on it, one for M2 ball, the other for M1 ball, which is a heavy ball equivalent. Now, the big fact that's left out of the argument, for extreme range plunging fire, area fire techniques, the heavy ball ammunition gives you a 5,500 yard range versus the 3,300 yard range of the light ball ammunition. This is the basic difference between the 7.62 Nato and the 30-06. Now, this may not seem important to you, but in asymmetrical warfare, where you have armies that don't have a lot of support weapons, you'll notice that the heavy ball ammunition has a similar range to that of the 81 and 82 millimeter mortar systems. When you take a topographical map, a compass, and a heavy machine gun or a general purpose machine gun, set it up on a tripod, and use a forward observer, you can engage area targets between 2,000 and 5,000 meters. This is important to armies that don't have integral fire supports. Please rate, comment, subscribe. We'll see you on the next video.